Does this happen to you? In this video, I'm going to show you my favorite stretch for flexible knees. Welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, I'm Marcia, and every week I share with you a yoga tip for jiu-jitsu. So make sure that you hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of them. Jiu-jitsu can be quite taxing on our knees, so we want to make sure that we keep our knees flexible. It's important to know that the knees are a joint, so it's really the muscles around it that you need to stretch. I'm going to show you a pose, Ardha Baddha Padma Paschimottanasana, or half lotus pose, that will help you keep your knees flexible and also teach you to stretch the muscles around it. Jiu-jitsu can be quite taxing on the knees. I'm going to show you my favorite stretch that I like to do every single day to make sure that I keep my knees flexible. So let's start. You're going to put your legs out into Dandasana, keeping the idea that you're drawing your toes back towards your head and your heels away from you. That's going to lengthen the backsides of your legs. Stay here for a few breaths. You can start to create that sense of evenness between the right side and the left side in your sit bones, extending all the way out through your heels. As you draw the toes back, you should feel a nice lengthening through the back of the legs, and then try pressing your femur bones down to keep a little bit of stability there as well. Now, after you've stayed here for a few breaths and you feel nice and even, let's move into the actual pose. So Ardha Baddha Padma means half lotus. So we're gonna move one of our legs into that half lotus idea. I wanna always support my knee as I bring it in. So I'm gonna draw my leg in and then place my foot hopefully close to my hip, but maybe that's not accessible for everyone. So make sure that when you are placing your foot, the only place that you don't put it is right on the other knee. That's gonna cause compression but pressing it down that you're not gonna like later on. So find a spot where you can put your foot that's comfortable. Again, preferably as close to the hip as possible, because that's also gonna give a nice stretch to your ankle here. Now, my knee doesn't come to the floor as a lot of people don't. So this is where we could use a blanket, or if you're just at the gym, your gi top is the perfect thing. I can put it under my hip here or under my thigh and it'll support my leg so that I can move into the stretch with a little bit more ease. Now, this is nice here because I have this closing action which you need to be comfortable with in jiu-jitsu, and I also have an opening action on the other knee. Obviously, when we switch sides, each knee is going to get that equal stretch. So sitting here for a little bit might be enough for you. So just taking that into account, if you're not ready to go forward, just use this stretch as your beginner phase. If you feel like you can do a little bit more, we can take our belt, wrap it around the ball of that other foot, and start to extend forward. Now again, we always want to start with that concave back phase as we start to move ourselves towards the foot. I'm actually thinking I'm going to put my chin over my foot, not my head down to my knee. So staying here for a few breaths, keep extending out through this knee so that it's releasing into your gi or your blanket or maybe even the floor, and then start moving yourself forward. Staying here for a few breaths, maybe walking your hands down closer to your foot as you get a little bit more into the stretch. So again, you will feel the muscles around the knee stretching here, and this is a nice closed action on this knee here. The next phase, you're just gonna start to bend your elbows out and lower yourself down, really closing the gap between your foot and your rib cage. And then as you start to release down towards the leg, you move further into the pose. Keep extending out through the heel, drawing the toe back, keep this leg nice and lengthened, and always putting the femur bone down towards the floor to keep it nice and stable. 5 to 10 breaths, and then on your next inhale, coming all the way out. Now, making sure that you take care of bringing this knee out of the pose, you want to bring your hands back under it, extend the leg out, and then we would return to Dandasana. So that's the staff pose with both legs facing forward. Again, repeat the drawing the heels away, toes coming towards the head, and stay here for 5 to 10 breaths before you repeat this pose on the other side. So that's Ardha Baddha Padma Paschimottanasana, half lotus pose. Such a great pose if you're playing that leg locking game right now. If you got any value out of that video, make sure you hit the like button, share it with your friends, and leave a comment. Let me know what's ailing you right now and I can help you find a stretch for it. Thanks for watching.